Alors oui, c'est sûr que des biais, il y en a beaucoup. Il y a les biais clairs, évidents, comme par exemple quand en politique ou ailleurs une femme élève la voix ou se fâche, on va dire qu'elle est hystérique. Si un homme fait la même chose, on va dire qu'il est courageux, fort et déterminé. Il y a aussi des biais un peu plus subtils, un peu plus insidieux, comme par exemple on vous exclut d'un projet important, on vante votre charme, votre élégance, ou même le body language des hommes peut en dire long. Pour ma part, moi j'étais la première femme à être ministre des Transports dans mon pays. C'est un domaine évidemment 100% masculin. Ça n'a pas été facile, j'ai fait l'objet beaucoup de remarques, mais justement c'était l'occasion de commencer à changer les stéréotypes et aujourd'hui, la patronne des chemins de fer belges est une femme.
Well, unconscious bias does exist, and I would like to give you a very unusual example. At the beginning of my career, when I worked as a journalist, I received an education in the sphere of international economic affairs. I received a telephone call from one of my authors, and he asked for a meeting. I was sure he wants to give another interview to our newspaper. Instead, he said that he was just appointed the first ever Soviet ambassador to the European Union and looking for the future staff for his mission, he saw that I fit one of the diplomatic positions and he wants to offer me this position. And he said, well, Tatiana, are you ready to go to Brussels? And I said, but how can this be possible? I am a girl. And he said, well, I've noticed. And also laughed, because at that period in my country, that was absolutely impossible to send a girl to work abroad. It was a certain bias. We were trained, we received a good profession, good education, but international affairs, international negotiations, diplomacy, was not a work fit for women, it was considered. It was an obvious bias, and of course we had to fight it.
The slip that I am often confronted with is when students and others refer to me as Mrs. Pozo, but to my male colleagues as Dr. Smith. I admit it is annoying, but I sort of get it. For years and years in grammar and secondary school, my students have had mostly female teachers who are addressed as Mrs. or Ms. They carry that picture over to the university. After being corrected that I am indeed Dr. Pozo, the next slip is to assume that I only teach introductory classes and that I never had kids because if I had, I would have quit.
Alors l'important, c'est de ne pas laisser passer les biais, de tous les détecter, quitte à parfois apparaître un peu comme l'empêcheuse de tourner en rond, si d'ailleurs on peut les relever avec humour, c'est encore mieux. Puis par ailleurs, il faut chercher des alliances avec les hommes, entre autres, parce qu'il y a beaucoup d'hommes qui pensent aussi que l'égalité des genres, c'est important. Il faut pouvoir utiliser toutes les discriminations positives mises à votre disposition. Je pense que c'est utile de pouvoir les employer. Vous êtes compétente, vous devez être sûre de vous, de la capacité que vous avez à faire le job pour lequel vous êtes nominée. Et enfin, il faut aussi ne pas fermer la porte ou tirer l'échelle quand on est arrivé en haut. Je crois que c'est important aussi d'encourager les autres, d'encourager les jeunes et de pouvoir aussi aider les autres à progresser et à réussir.
Well, you have to admit that biases, conscious or unconscious, exist. And once you admit this, you have to fight them. And for me, to fight a bias is always the same strategy. You have to be the best. The best way to fight the bias is to show that you are the best in your profession, you are the best in your field, that you can compete, that you can be professional. And that's really very, very important, because if you prove you are the best, then it's easier for other generations of young girls and women to fight the bias. So another part of the strategy, if you managed to fight a bias yourself, if you managed to start a career in the field which has been not open for women before, you have to support others. You have to support and promote young girls, young women, give them all the possibility to have a career and to prove that they are also the best.
I am a professor, and my style is to seize on teaching moments, use the opportunity to educate. I am not a single story. Yes, I am a Mrs., but I am also Dr. Pozzo. I am a wife and mother, but I am also a scholar of economics. I thoroughly enjoy getting to know first-year university students by teaching introductory economics classes. But I also supervise PhD students, and I teach PhD level classes. I publish state-of-the-art economic research. I am a Latina too, even if I don't justify your expectations of what a Latina looks or sounds like. I am not a single story. You might envision me in one dimension, but there are many more sides to me. It is best to not fall into the trap of taking those shortcuts which lead to the single story. Train yourself to stop summing people up in one dimension. Give the person in front of you space to tell their story. No one is a single story.